Hey, we are here with Damima Duffield. Maybe you can just tell us, how was the Impala Derby for you?
Well, the Impala Derby for me, obviously it's going to be a very emotional game. It's always, a derby is always an emotional game. But I think coming off the blocks, Impala were a little quicker, got into the systems quicker. At some point, yes, Queens were leading, but Impala got back on top and they just sort of kept that momentum. I feel that, especially with the backs, Impala today were more superior, and with the forwards at some point, you notice that once you cut out, or rather shut out the Queens forwards, Impala had a much easier day.
Yeah.
But in terms of set pieces like the line out, I think Queens had a better day.
Yeah. And just going into the next match, KCB are going to meet Impala again. What's your predictions, or where's your money?
Well, to be honest, I mean, as an Impala supporter, I'll go with Impala, but it's going to be a very tough game.
Yeah.
I think it depends on mentally who's on top on the day. Impala seem to be KCB's bogey team, but it depends on whose systems work on the day and who just wants it more and grinds to the end.
And for guys who might not know who you are, maybe you can just tell them your journey in the sport and you being your staunch rugby supporter. Where did your love for the game start to now, where you are right now in terms of just broadcast?
A long time ago, 2009, I started actually just watching rugby, because I'm generally big on most sports. I've always been, I played sports through prep school, high school, you know, played a little bit of club hockey, but then I started watching at Impala, and that's how I ended up supporting Impala. I played for Mwamba though, like 2 years after I started watching, I started playing for Mwamba, got called up to the national team, didn't really play much, it was sort of on and off, you know, work and things like that. But I mean, rugby is one of those games where once you're in, I mean, that's it. It's very hard to leave. You get sucked in, passion for the game, you know. So, yeah, then broadcasting just sort of happened. I mean, you know, you're looking for work here and there. Then there was a production company. They needed a female presenter, someone who, you know, enjoys the game, supports the game, understands the game, and also can stand in front of the camera. And that kind of, you know, was learning on the job, but it's a good experience. And here I am. I mean, now I'm with the Three Quarters Podcast, as you know. And even there, you learn every day. I mean, you learn from each other, like I learn from you, you learn from me, and yeah.
And for females who are, let's say, outside of their sport, and they might want to be get into the sport either as a fan or just as a player, what would be your words of wisdom to them?
To be honest, give it a try.
Yeah.
I mean, from the outside looking in, rugby looks like a very physical, rough sport. You know, women aren't supposed to be there, but it's a sport like any other.
Yeah.
It's got its rules, it's got its sanctions. Just come, give it a try. It's one of the more complex sports, so if you're smart, come. That's a challenge for you.
Yeah.
So definitely come and join. We always need more women in the sport. The women's game has really grown. I mean, if you look at the likes of Impala and Nakuru, who didn't have teams before, you know, the university teams, you've got your Kenyatta University, USIU Rugby. I mean, Mwamba, of course, started rugby. You've also now got Northern Suburbs, which sort of pulled away from KCB. But women's game is growing, and we're always encouraging girls to come and join us.
And speaking of the women's game, maybe you can just tell us or give us your 2 cents. What do you think the new women's game needs to do so that we can go to the next level in terms of just local rugby, and also the Kenya women's team in terms of the Kenya women's sevens? I believe they're going to the Commonwealth and the other games. What do you think the team needs so that they can grow as a team?
All right, well, all I can tell, from my perspective, what I'd say is we need to support the women. I mean, at some point, the men's game was small, yeah? And because of the support of the fans and support of corporate, it's become much bigger, and that's what we need for the women. I mean, with literally almost nothing, they have grown the game by themselves. You know, they've been sort of playing without allowance or delayed allowance, you know, things like that. But we need to back them. We need to be there. We need to support them, because they're playing out of, it's just heart, basically. So we need to get behind them as corporates. Take a chance. Why not?
And for guys who are watching you on social media, maybe they might want to follow your channel. Maybe you can just share with them where they can get your channel or just follow you.
All right, well, personally, I'm on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. So on Facebook, it's Damima Duffield. On Instagram, it's Amimad Damima. And on Twitter, it's Damimatron. But also, you can find me on the Three Quarters podcast. That is both on, that's actually on Twitter, on Facebook, and on Instagram. Yeah.
And is broadcasting the only thing that you do, or there are other things that you do on the side?
Well, I do other things. I mean, the Three Quarters podcast is actually a passion project for now. I mean, for me, it's all about spreading the rugby gospel. And like I said, I'm very passionate about sports in general. So that doesn't actually, you know, put food on the table for me. But I do artist management with a record label called Pine Creek. Just started recently, actually. It's a small label, handling just a few artists. But yes, that's what I do from my 9-to-5, basically. Yes.
So you handle artists and yeah, you're a good event, so...
Well, yes, generally I do events, but not for my day job. That's just handling them, that's basically coordinating things for them. But I generally, on a yearly basis, I'm part of, you know, the Impala Floodlit Tournament, Safari Sevens, from an organizational point of view. That's coordination is one of my strong points, and that's how I got into actually the job I'm doing now.
And there are also other guys, the Slay Kings, who are watching you. Is Damima on the market, or can they jump in the DM?
I think if you feel you need to,
yeah.
Slide, you'll find out. Yeah.